Hi lovely people, welcome once again to my YouTube channel. I'm really excited about this month of December. Welcome to December! Yes, I'm excited because we're starting off the new series that I've been raving about. Yes, the What I Learned series. So, and today will be our very first episode on that series. And on today's episode, I'll be sharing 5 important lessons that I learned while I was at the university. So it's coming right up. So lesson number one, do not take for granted the people that God has placed in your life. You know how it is when we go to school, you know, people that have been living with their parents and then it's sort of like you don't have freedom. And then you go to the university and it's like you have all the freedom in the world. Like you can do whatever you want to do, go to wherever you want to go to. You choose to go to classes, you choose to go to church or not. It's, you know, you are the boss of yourself. Yes, but there are people that God has placed intentionally in our path. I talked about the categories of people in my previous video. Check it out here. There are people that God placed intentionally in our paths to help us, to guide us. Now, because our parents are not there, there are people that will come and act as if that they are parents figures. Now, let me give you an example. When I was at the university, my 100 level, I wasn't very consistent in going to a particular church. I was going from church to church. I felt that I had the freedom. I can attend different churches. So I wasn't really deeply rooted in a particular church. And then there were people that God placed intentionally in my life to guide me, to help me to make the right choices. And initially I was like, please, I'm a big girl. You know, I know what I want to do. I make my decisions myself. But then the hostel where me, my sister and a friend of mine were living at, because my sister joined us later on, when I was in 200 level, there was a particular brother God placed in my path. And you know, he was always calling me, advising me and telling me. At some point I'm like, this one, your advice is becoming too much. But there's a particular day, I think it was Valentine's Day, he invited us and said his church was having a program that we should all come. And we felt, oh, that's cool, we should go and have some fun. We went to the church and it was a Bible study day. It was a Tuesday actually, in 2012, February 14th. And to tell you the truth, nothing about Valentine was said. The message was preached. But then something caught me. I loved the community of believers that I met that day. And I also decided to go back the next Sunday. And from there, I joined the workforce. And that was the starting point of, you know, beautiful things happening in my spiritual life. So yeah, God placed that brother in my life at that particular time to help me. Even though at that 200 level, I could have as well continued the life that I was living, going from church fellowship to fellowship. I didn't really want to commit at one place because I felt I didn't want to, like, you know, be held bound. I want to be free. But then I'm glad that I listened, I yielded to that counsel, and I joined the workforce. And that was really the beginning of beautiful things in my life. So yes, do not take for granted the people that God has placed in. I have a lot of other examples, but this is just one. So if you are in school right now and then there is that brother or there is that sister that is always coming to you and advising you, and you're feeling like, please, this brother, please stay on your lane, let me be, please, I would advise you, listen, I would advise you to take heed to counsel now that you can, so you don't fall into error. That's lesson number one. Lesson number two, you cannot sit on the fence, pick a side. In the university campus, there are people that are for God, there are people they call the spirikoko, the people that are the campus fellowship people, and there are those that are neither here nor there. They are moved away by every wind of doctrine. Sometimes they go to fellowship, some other times they just want to live whatever life that they desire to live. My advice, what I learned is that you cannot sit on the fence. You have to pick a side. You are either for God or you are not for God. Even scripture says that you are either hot or cold. You can't be lukewarm. You can't be in the middle. If you stand on the express road in the middle of the road, cars coming from this side can hit you. Cars coming from behind can hit you. You are either on this side or on the other side. Now, one thing I've really learned about choosing a side is that you are focused. You know, yes, this is what I want to do. I want to be for the people of God. And while you are in the community of brethren, community of the people of God, you get to meet people that would encourage you, that would pray with you, that would help you grow. But if you are not committed to a fellowship, if you're not committed to the community of Christians on campus, you are just on your own, then anything can happen to you. Like, there's nobody responsible for you. That's the truth of the matter. You cannot sit on the fence. You have to pick a side. You are either for God or you are not for God. Even those people that are on the other side of the fence, they know the people that are for God. They know the people that, you know, are committed to fellowship, and they know the people that are for them. So yeah, please pick a side. Do not sit on the fence. Lesson number three, the semester is never long. Do not be deceived. The semester is not long. Start reading at the beginning of the semester. Start doing all that you need to do when you need to do it. Do not be deceived, though, that I'm thinking, semester is 4 months. I still have time. You do not have time. I will tell you what happened to me, my friends. When we're preparing for our seminar, you know, we've been giving seminar topics and everything at the beginning of the semester, but then we shall know, we have time, we're doing small. You would not believe, the day before the seminar, that's when we're trying to put our slides together. None of us slept at night. We're putting things together, and then on the day of the seminar, that morning, that's when we're printing our seminar papers and spiral binding them. You needed to see me that day. I was on my toes, like I was restless. In the end, we gave our seminar. God came through for us, yes, but after everything, you needed to see how tired, how exhausted we were. We could have avoided all that if we had started what we needed to do at the beginning. Of course, in the beginning, we'll be doing small. This is chapter one. We say, there is time. At least I've done chapter one. There are people that have not even done chapter one. But I would advise, start reading at the beginning of the semester. Start your work early so you can have enough time so you don't break down. A lot of people broke down preparing for seminar, preparing for projects, studying for exams because they piled up their work until the last minute. Do not pile your work until the last minute. The semester is never long. It is very short. Start early, start doing what you need to do early, and you will not break down. That is lesson number three. Lesson number four, learn a skill. As much as you have the time to, please learn a skill. That's something I couldn't do while I was at the university. And thinking back on it now, I really wish I had learned a skill because I saw a lot of my classmates that could do a lot of things. They could bake, they could dress hair, they could make clothes. And this was like a form of extra income for them because school is a very wonderful business base. Like it's a very wonderful customer base for, you know, whatever business, whatever skill that you have. So if you're not yet in the university, while you're waiting to get into school, try to learn a skill. It will come in very handy. After your parents have sent you what they've sent you for the month, there are other expenses that we incur upon ourselves, and then there are those that are necessary. So for those ones that we incur upon ourselves, at least it would be wonderful to have a second source of income. It was already too late before I realized that I needed to learn a skill, and then at the time, there were a lot of workloads in my hand. If you're in school currently, the holiday is the perfect time to learn a skill. It could be a hand skill, it could be tailoring, it could be baking, it could be photography, whatever interests you, whatever drives your passion, learn a skill. It could be an IT skill, yeah, it could be a computer skill, technological skill, whatever it is, learn a skill. Make use of the opportunities that you have during your holiday season to learn a skill. It will come in very handy. Honestly, it will come in very handy. Lesson learned. Finally, lesson number five, last but not the least. Define your relationships. My goodness, the university is it's a big place for a lot of relationships. You meet a lot of people from different backgrounds, from different upbringings, a lot of people, beautiful people, handsome people, people with good characters, people with terrible characters. You meet a lot of people, and then it's, you know, it's a thriving ground for relationships. I'm not just talking about dating relationships, other relationships, both academic relationships, you know, relating with people, just being friends with people. What I learned while I was in university was the fact that you need to define your relationships. Know why you are hanging out with this person. Is it for academic reasons, for academic purposes? Is it for to grow ourselves spiritually? Are we book partners? Are we reading partners? You know, am I attracted to this person? And if I'm to say yes to going out with this person, what's the purpose of the relationship? Are we going to end up married? Like, what exactly, what's the benefit? What am I going to derive from this relationship? It's very important to sit down and define your relationships. And then when you're hanging out with someone and you realize that you're starting to catch feelings and things are happening, my goodness, that's the best time to bring your brain into the equation. Do not think with your heart. To tell you the truth, there's so much on your plate already, your schoolwork, you know, your a lot of things that you're looking to become. You know, the school is a molding ground for a lot of things. So I don't think it's the right time to look into dating relationships, but if that's what you desire, it's important that you define it and know, why am I in this relationship with this person? Where is this relationship heading to? What are we doing? Like, how are we helping each other's life? There must be benefits, of course. It must be mutually beneficial. So as Christians, yes, because I'm a Christian, I would always say, as Christians, define your relationships. Do not assume that the other person knows I don't have feelings for them, or do not assume that the other person knows that I have feelings for them. A lot of things have gone wrong. A lot of things have gone wrong by assumption. So do not assume. Define your relationships to yourself, and then have a talk with this other person, the people you're involved with, and talk about, what is this relationship about? I mean, what are we doing? Where are we going? So it's important to open your mouth and talk, because assumption would send you into error, like massive error. And there are a lot of people that are falling into that error of assumption, and it was very difficult to come out of it. So lesson number 5, define your relationships. And that is the end of today's episode. I am super excited. So join me for next episode next week, Friday. I'll be talking about something equally interesting. So please, I would like you guys to leave your comments in the comment section. Let me know, what did you learn in your university? I mean, the period you spent in school, what lesson really can you put out there for the young ones that are reading, that are coming up, so they will not make the same mistakes that you made? So let me know in the comment section, and please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.